A week after the Formula One Bahrain Grand Prix in April 2017, Bahraini female activist Najah Ahmed Youssef was arrested for her social media post criticizing the holding of the F1 Grand Prix in Bahrain. She was tortured at Al Muharraq police station for 4 days, 8 hours at a time. In her own words, Najah describes the ordeal. If I wrote down the violations I was subjected to, it would be a book. They insulted my honor and dignity. They physically assaulted me, removed my headscarf, tried to tear off my clothes and touch my sexual organs. They threatened me with rape and threatened to kill or put my sons in prison. All of this in the presence of plainclothes officers. Najah was told to sign a pre-prepared confession without reading it. When she refused to sign it, Najah was violently beaten, kicked, and sexually abused. A thug was specifically brought into the police station to frighten her with rape. When she could not take no more, she signed, and for that, she was given a 3-year sentence in June 2018. Muharraq Police Station, where she was tortured, is a beneficiary of the training provided by the UK Foreign Office. In August 2015, Brigadier Fawaz Hassan, the current head of the Muharraq Police Station, received direct training provided by the UK Foreign Office in Belfast. A month after Najah's torture, another female human rights activist, Ibtassem Al-Saeeq, was tortured in the same British trained police station. It was for punishment for her testimony at the United Nations Human Rights Council in Geneva. Upon returning to Bahrain, she was arrested and taken to the Muharraq police station, where she was savagely tortured. She was blindfolded and sexually assaulted and threatened with rape if she did not put an end to her human rights activities. She was brutally beaten and had to be rushed to hospital after the interrogation. Al-Saeeq told Amnesty, "The men told me no one can protect you. They took away my humanity. I was weak prey to them." Bahraini thugs, having guaranteed from the British government during training courses paid for by the British taxpayer, are guilty of rampant human rights abuses, including murdering peaceful protesters and torturing women and children. Shame on the British government!
Shame on the British government!
Shame on the British government!